Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Ultimate Fishing Simulator 2, the playtest. And we got the last lake from the playtest. What is the name? The Kurili Lake, it's called. It reminds me a little bit of Kuro Lake. And I need to say, guys, I already fished a little bit here. And I need to say, it looks really, really cool. It's very nice. One of the best areas that I ever saw in a fishing game, graphic-wise. So you guys will see it right away. The fish in this area, European eel, silver carp, Prussian carp, Amur pike, they look really cool. Tench, beluga, sturgeon, black grayling, chum salmon, coho salmon and pink salmon. And I already fished there with the top waters and I didn't get an eel. That's already very good. I got a beluga sturgeon once again on the top water. That's not so good. But what I saw was that I found a very good spot for tench and silver carp. And I was throwing with my top waters, but they don't bite. I switched to corn and I get right away a fish. So maybe they already try to go for like bait preference, what was really needed in the video that I said yesterday. But yeah, it's still fresh. And I need to say it looks really cool. You guys will see it right away. So we are going to use in the video three setups. So one is a starting setup. That's with like just an earthworm. The next one is a 9 kilogram setup. With the feeder and corn. And then my last one is just my heavy setup. The heaviest spinning setup that you can have. And this is a topwater. It seems that you can go max drag in this game too. Yesterday somebody said that, and there is a fatigue system, so I'm going with very heavy line on this setup. And let's get going, guys. So we are just going to fish, and you will see right away what I mean. It can be a little bit laggy because I had problems, because it's the second time that I tried to record it. But the first time it was a little bit... I was losing FPS, so that's not so good. But you guys can see right away, it looks really, really good. It was stunning for me. I came here, I was like, whoa, this is very well done. So you got a very small river. It comes in a very big lake, and here is the lake too. And there is a castle here. Can you see it? It's probably on the rocks over there. So you guys can see it here, it looks very cool. And what we are going to do is, we are going to fish a little bit. So here I had the beluga on the top water lure, so let's have a look that they are still here. Just the same again, I'm going now with maximum drag, because it does not seem to matter that much. But let's start at 90, just to be sure. So let's have a look, and it's once again a little bit lagging at the moment. I hope that it stays stable. And I hope that we can catch something. So what I'm going to do first is, I'm going to go around a little bit with the topwater lure. Then we are going to the area that I got a lot of silver carp. We are going to fish over there with feeders. It was over here. So there is like a little lake or pond. And it's totally full with tench and silver carp. So I'm going to show you guys that. Then we are going a little bit to the north, to the rocks. And there was like the Amur pike that you can get. So that's not bad. Very nice fish. And if I cannot catch them, I got them in my net. So I can show you guys it. So this feels really dead at the moment. So we are going to move a little bit. And here is somewhere like a log, and you can just cross the river here. So let's throw a couple of times over here. Maybe there is some fish over here. I can use my eagle eye too, because this is on normal mode. Did you guys saw that? Was once again, I was lagging for a brief moment. I still need to get the coho salmon. The pink salmon I already got. And the other salmon. There are three, I think, if I'm not mistaken. And there is something jumping here. So you guys, I just heard something jumping. So I think there is a fish over here. Let's have a look that we can get him. Because this is the beauty about this game, and this is really well done. So if you see fish jumping, you can just throw on their face, and yeah, sometimes they are biting if you got, of course, the right lure or bait. And I don't really have a problem with this, so that you need to find the fish. Because, to be honest, you can catch a lot of fish in this game if you saw Kiel. And then Slovakia was even worse. It was like non-stop fish, every throw a fish. But sometimes I like to try to find the fish, and if you got a very good spot, you can just fish it out, and then you go a little bit further, like real life fishing, I guess. So this is a position that I didn't fish yet, and you guys can see right away the difference. So I came here the first time, and I had right away a lot of action on the top water, and now it's very dead. I don't even see fish swimming. Normally you see fish swimming, and then you know that spot is active, but at the moment it's not the case. There was a jumper. Did you guys saw it? Maybe we can try to get him. There is another jumper. So they are... Oh, here. Oh, yeah. This is what I told you guys. This is a beluga. A little bit strange to get a beluga on the top water. A lure, once again. So I hope that they just put that away. Just put it on a shrimp or something. Or something else. But don't let it bite on top water lure like that the whole time. I got two kind of fish here. That's a sturgeon. That's the pike. And it was both on the top water, so let's have a look, because we had a jumper against the rock. Maybe we can stand on the dock over there. Maybe that's like a very good fishing place. Let's go to the dock. This is a very good beluga spot. This is another beluga. I think I put already one in my aquarium, so you can put them in the aquarium, so he's probably going to be dead tomorrow when I wake up again. But let's have a couple of throws here on the dock. Yeah, and it's not very good. I think coded this one, because all the other lakes I didn't have a problem with lagging, but now I got the impression that I'm sometimes lagging a little bit. And it's maybe the internet connection, because my frames, it seems not to go down. So can we get one more fish over here? And then we are going to do some teleport magic. And we are going to the small lake over there. No, it's dry, guys. So two belugas. Okay, let's have a look. Now we are going to switch for a brief moment. I'm going back to two. Then I'm going over the log. Over here. Then I'm going to equip my feeder setup. So you can come over here. If my avatar wants to jump. Yeah. And if you come over here. Here is like the little... And it looks really cool. Something like that I want to have in my... Yeah, I need to hit for... Okay, it's done. Yes, sometimes I got that. Don't ask me why. Sometimes I start running and I don't stop anymore. And then I just hit my keyboard very hard. So what we are going to do now is... I'm going to switch to the feeder setup. We don't yet have like bells in the game. So I'm going to look with my underwater camera. And this was a really good spot. I saw a lot of silver carp here. There was like a crucian carp too. I think he was doing very strange stuff. If I see him again, I will show you guys it. He was like dancing. There you go. I'm not sure what those fish are doing, but you need to watch this. It's so strange what they are doing. It's like, yeah, dancing or something. So yeah, I'm not sure what they are doing. It's very strange. I never saw a fish doing stuff like that, to be honest. So, the corn is out. Let's have a look. What we can get here. Yeah, I cannot see the bite, of course. Normally, I can... Yeah, oh, there is already the silver carp. Told you guys it. Very good spot for the silver carp, this one. So you just come here with a little bit of corn, you throw it in, and it's magic, this place. So here is a silver carp, and that's very good. This was the position that I didn't get the silver carp on the top water, and I was really happy with it, because that's how you need to fish for them. So you can put some corn on, some other stuff that you can put on. Okay, let's have a look that we can get another one, and then we are going to the last spot of today where I got the pike, and then I'm going to end the video, guys. What I saw too was, I think that they are going to extend the playtest with 1 week, another silver carp, with 1 week or something. So that's not bad, so we can play 1 week more. It's a pity, because I was expecting a little bit more gear or something, but it was not coming. I guess this is just going to be some testing for the areas, and probably the gear will come a little bit later. So, now we are coming to here. And you guys will see, now we are getting to the, like, the very big lake here. And here I had a couple of tench. Let's have a look with my bobber setup. I guess it's number 2 or number 1. Yeah, number 1. So let's have a look that we can get some tench here. I was looking for the crucian, but I didn't yet get the crucian. I would think that he bites on a worm, but that was not the case. Maybe I need to go with bread or something. Let's have a look that I can get another tench over here. Let's zoom a little bit like a pro. Because with my massive bobber, I need a zoom function. Going to reel a little bit in. Just go to another position. Here we go. This feels very dead, because I don't see fish swimming around here. It can happen. Sometimes a position that you got a lot of fish on is not active anymore a little bit later. Because you can see it right away. Normally you got a lot quicker a bite. Let's reel a little bit more. Nope, I think it's that, guys. So let's go to the next spot, and that was the Amur Pike spot. So it was here on the rocks that I got one. So if you come here, yeah, did you guys saw it? That was a very bad leg spike. I'm wondering how the video is going to look. I hope it's still worth to upload it. So here I got the pike. And there were like pikes swimming around, and here is like, what is this in eye? Okay, it's gone. So let's have a look that we can get another pike. And the funny part is that the first time that I came, there is one, but it's a beluga, this one. The first time that I came here, I saw a lot of more fish swimming too. Let's go full drag, because you can do it in this game. Let's have a look that I can break some shit. No, just full drag, guys. Yeah, somebody said it to me. You never think about that stuff, because yeah, if you do full drag in a fishing game, most of the time you break your shit, but here you can just do it. Here we go. Beluga sturgeon, 23 kilograms, just like that. Let's have a look. because I want to show you guys the pike Amur or Amur pike. I'm going to do a couple of more throws and then I'm going to end the video. So what I see is, and I got that feeling at the moment too, so I got at the start of this game, I had like I wanted to play this game a lot, but now with the weeks going on, it's okay, it's a new area, but there it stops. I'm now level 22, but I don't have the need anymore to play this game a lot. I saw it, that's good. So I saw the areas, but now at some point there is not really a goal anymore for me. So maybe get every fish here, but gear-wise I got all the gear that I can have in the playtest. Level-wise it does not matter really that much. So for me, and I see that a lot too, I see it on the players too in-game. I think a lot of people jumped on it the first and the second week. The third was already a little bit less. But that's normal, because what do we get now? We got a new area and there it stops. And that's what I always tell people too. In a fishing game, you can make a game that it's all about just fishing. You can do that, but at some point you get a fish and then it's done. So there always need to be some game aspects in fishing games too. If you see the most successful fishing games that are around, it's leveling, it's trying to achieve stuff and all that stuff. And that's very important in a game. And now at the moment I don't have that anymore with this game. So I saw it all, I got everything. And that's okay for me. We did some testing and that's very good. So the developers know what they need to do. And what is this? Don't say it's a silver carp. No, it's a salmon that I did not yet get. It's the coho, very nice. So in the video, and that's a very nice ender. Let's keep this one. And I'm going to show you guys to end the video how the Amur pike looks, because here it is. It's very beautiful. I need to say it looks very beautiful. So thanks for watching, guys. Have fun in the new area. And I see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.